Welcome to World of Warcraft episode 23. I'm your host, Lostwolfe. And before we get going, I want to tell you the story of Grimclaw, because this is minor tragedy. Sort of sums up what's going on at large in this zone. So Grimclaw was a bear before the Cataclysm who had a master called Warcraft. And Warcraft used to live out in a cave, which I don't think exists anymore because of the Cataclysm. Well, he didn't live there, he got trapped there. And you were helping another night elf further up the road from where Volker was hiding out. And the whole idea was that Volker was trapped, but his bear understood enough to know that he was trapped. So he came and warned this other night elf guy. And the night elf guy then sent you off on a mission to go and help Volker and get Volker and Grimclaw back together again. The way that happened was he ended up making a cape for you, which granted you temporary invisibility and you could sneak in and help Falkor and Grimclaw, and then they would be reunited. So Falkor and Grimclaw were, you know, like a hunter team, basically. After the Cataclysm, Falkor ended up over here by Orbedain, which is a destroyed area that we saw yesterday. And he saw that Grimclaw was hurt, but he couldn't do anything. So, this is spoiler territory, by the way, so if you don't want to hear this, then don't listen. I'll put text up to tell you when you can listen if you're going to plan to play this bit of the game. But basically, Grimclaw's master died. So he ends up dead, and Grimclaw ends up hurt. During the quest for this particular version of events, this is after the Cataclysm, you help Volkor, and you take him down to, you end up helping him all the way back down to the big city that we saw up north. And then a couple of phases occur, and as the phases occur, first you see Grimclaw and he's alone. And then eventually Grimclaw ends up with a new master, and this it's a Night Elf lady. I don't remember her name, sorry, but that is basically the story of Grimclaw. Now that kind of thing is writ large all across Darkshore, which is one of the reasons why it's not a zone I'm going to particularly do. The people that we're looking for, I think, are just to the north, actually. Because my plan had been, as I said, to get cloth. And then I ran a bit further north than I needed to be, but further south than I needed to be. I'm looking for cultist guys, and they are evidently over here, I think. Oh, goodness. Hello, guy. These creatures are sort of on level for me, because if you end up doing the Night Elf zone, then this is the next zone that you see. There you see, I got like 1,100 experience, which is great, but not what I wanted. I think these guys are further in this way. If I can get up there, let's find out. Oh, I totally can. So where are these people I'm looking for? I'm looking for dark cultist guys who evidently have a lot of cloth. Twilight fanatic, there we go. That would be them. Now, I'm not going to pull too many of them because that would be a bad idea. Embrace the end. The Twilight Cultists are basically a group of people that believe that the end times are upon the world of Azeroth. It's not a religious thing, it's just that's what they think. And they think that as a result of the Cataclysm. There we go. This is a bit of a grind, Which is okay. I mean, sometimes you have to do a little bit of that. Let's freeze this guy so that we don't have a problem when he starts hitting us. Oh, I counterspelled. He wasn't casting a spell. I keep doing that. Oh, there we go. We got some cloth. In fact, we got 3 cloths, which is pretty good. Oh, I should have... I had both stacks of feeding up there. Ah, well. Oh, goodness. He's gonna go call a friend. Phone a friend. Oh. Yeah, he's gonna phone a friend. That's okay. If he phones a friend, we might end up with our cloth even faster. There we go. Let's see, what have we got? Ah, we got 1. That's okay. It means we need 6 more. So while I'm doing this little bit of a grind, let me tell you a grinding story. Because they're always fun, right? Long ago, back when the game's cap was 60, one of the things that the devs used to do was they used to hide, oh goodness, I didn't see you at all. They used to hide patterns inside of dungeons. Much like you saw the cloth bag drop for me a couple of weeks ago, or about a week ago. And what this meant was that in order to get those patterns, you had to basically do those, instances over and over and over again. Now, at the time when I was 60, I didn't really want to do that because that seemed a little bit crazy. So I waited until the Burning Crusade came out, and then I went in and I started doing those dungeons almost exclusively, like just by myself, because I could, and it worked out. And the way it ended up working was, because there was one guy I had to kill, and if I could kill him, then I could loot him very quickly. I could grab whatever was on his corpse. But I couldn't kill everyone around him, because remember, this was like the jump from 60 to 70, and that wasn't a really big enough jump. And the gear wasn't really good enough to be able to take on still level 60 areas. Unless you were, you know, very good and you knew what you were doing. Because there were just a lot of people in those areas. Inside of the dungeons. And so, what ended up happening while I was there, and I wanted both an enchanting and a tailoring recipe, I had to basically go and take all my clothes off, beat up the guy as fast as I could, and then die, so I could get to the beginning, and I could start over, doing the same thing again. We've now got the 120 cloth we need, by the way. There we go. Ooh, hot springs. Let's hop in. And so I would, like, basically take all my clothes off, run to the point where the guy was at, because I could stealth as a cat, and then beat up just that one guy. So I'd beat him up, see if he dropped what I wanted, and then if he didn't, I would run away. I would actually stay put. I'd find a corner, I would stay put, and then I'd grab everyone and get myself killed, and then come out, and then do it again. And eventually, like after a long, long time, I got both formulas. Because my plan back then had been to be able to craft everything that you could craft in the game. I don't feel that way anymore, by the way. Because I stopped playing at the end of, like, heavily playing at the end of Cataclysm. I just didn't like the way Cataclysm broke the game. And so I didn't seriously play, so I missed out on a lot. And now I don't feel that way at all. No, it's all good. I can miss patterns and things, and it's okay. Hey. Someone's dueling. Okay, so I'm going to take you to Darnassus, because I want to show you around Darnassus, because Darnassus is really pretty. And then what's going to end up happening is I'm going to do a crafting thing, but I'm going to alt-tab, so you're going to see my browser window. And that's okay, because I need to introduce you to some of these websites, because that's important. I wonder if he's... Oh, he's a level 15 elite. Let's kill him. I don't know if this is a really bright idea or a really okay idea, because he's a elite and I'm kind of killing him while the NPCs are holding him. Let's run in and then at least stun him so they can hit a little harder. Yay, he died. Oh goodness, he's got little baby friends. That's not good. I got nothing but experience for that. And then there's another system I want to introduce you to while we're in Darnassus. So, it's a good thing that we're going there. Yeah, Lord and all. Okay. I'm not going to read the text here because we are not actually doing any of these quests. We are literally passing through so we can get to the Flightmaster. Who is open? Yeah. There. Okay.
Yushnuala.
We want to go to the throne village. I can actually go to Darnassus. Wow. Okay. Let's do that.
Be careful.
When all this is done, I'm going to get that slot back in my bag, because I'm going to basically empty out all of my linen cloth. So what is Teldrassil? Teldrassil is the great tree that the Night Elves made long, long ago. And then Teldrassil got corrupted and it was slowly dying. I don't know if that's still the case during the Cataclysm era, but that's basically what was happening in the time of the pre-Cataclysm, I should say, the world before the Cataclysm. This is going to be interesting because you never used to be able to kind of get down the great tree. Once you were up there, you had to take the portal. So seeing this is new for me. Like, completely so, in fact. These are old tree models, by the way, and that's why they look like giant triangles, as opposed to the pretty trees that Pandaria had. These are from kind of the game's inception. Wow, this is actually pretty cool. The key I used to turn off the interface is Alt-Z, for those who are curious about that. My flying panda. This I remember because you can hop off. You could hop off of here. Okay, we've seen this before. This is the bank, and the bank area's got the flight master and this guy here. The actual bank is assuming I remember. It is, oh, I don't think it is where I thought it was. Oh, it's over here. It's this building. This is the bank. On the command board. Okay, so this is Darnassus. Darnassus is the Night Elf area. This is their main city. It's really, really beautiful. There are a couple of things I want to show you before we actually get down to actually doing any of the stuff that we're supposed to do. But, it's going to take me like about a minute or two to get to where I want to be. These guys over here, this is what I wanted to show you. I'm not going to be able to get a very good picture of them. These are the ancient of war. These are the kind of the watchers that watch over Darnassus. And they're basically alive plants and trees and that kind of thing. There are lots of watchers and they all look pretty much like this. You can hear him creaking in the background there. Okay, so we want... Oh, the reason why we're getting this a bard, by the way. See this guy and what he's riding? These are sabers. I want to get us a saber because sabers are awesome and I've never had one. That's because Horde can't ride sabers. There are a couple of sabers that Horde can get and I never ever got any of them. Professions. We want tailoring. You would certainly be looking for Melon if you had any hope of learning to be a tailor. She resides at the Craftsman's Terrace in northeastern Darnassus.
Delnadris.
Okay. The way that Darnassus is set up is it's got a couple of terraces. This is the Craftsman's Terrace. Okay, tailoring trainer, that's what we need. All I remember about my tailoring is I've got to turn the cloth that we have into bolts of linen. So, okay, here's the interface for this. It's pretty simple, right? So what you do is you need to check whether or not you've got the amount of reagents. So if you do, like I have here, this is 120 of 2. It means that I can make 60 because I've got 120 and they take 2 to make. Different things cost different amounts of stuff. Like this is a bolt of linen cloth, which I can only make through the skill here. If they're like this and they're kind of gold, it means that you will guarantee yourself a skill up every time you use them. They go, World of Warcraft works in diminishing returns, so they'll go yellow, which means that you will definitely get a skill up. They'll go green, which means you might get a skill up, and then they'll go grey when you stop getting skills up, skill ups. We're going to create all of these. There we go. I increase to 2, 3, 4... And you can actually see that happening up here. Now, I'm not going to get the full 75 out of this because this is probably going to go grey at about 35 or so. But that's okay. We need all 60 of them. Don't watch this. This is not important. Watch the colour here. This is going to take a while. But my plan for today is to get us to 75 just so you can see how tailoring works. And then after that, once we hit a point where we can do a skill up, like a big bump like this, I'll just do it by myself so you don't have to watch it. But I thought it'd be instructive kind of to see this once, at least. There, okay. Now it's going yellow. So I will definitely get a skill up point, but not always. I'm probably going to get to 35. And, oh, that's interesting. Presumably, oh, there we go. I didn't get skill ups there. Because you can almost always get a skill up, but not always. So this is now green. I will almost never get a skill up from this. I'll just be making them. Oh, get me to 40. Come on. That's all I want. 39. Yay, 40. I might actually get to 41. Which is pretty good. That might negate a couple of the things I have to do, but I'm not going to worry about it. I'm going to make everything on the list. Oh, I got 42. That's pretty cool. Okay, so now that the formula I'm following thinks that you will get to 40, and then slowly but surely you'll do the rest, and that will get you to 45. Okay. So, we're going to Alt-Tab now. And we're going to look at one of the websites. Oh. Okay. So this is Wowhead. And Wowhead is a good website for looking up stuff. This is a guide that someone's written. Whose guide is it? I can't tell. Yeah, I can't tell. Maybe it's at the bottom. There. Oh, many thanks to the internet. Someone's just basically said the internet helped them write this. But basically, you can see it, that we need bought and gathered. These are things that you can find in the wall. You can get in an auction house. We need 120. We need... which will turn into 60 bolts of learning cloth. And we need 65 coarse thread, which we're going to buy now. I hope it's not too expensive. We need 65 of them. And the plan is that you'll follow this now. I got lucky and I got to 42, so I don't need to make three of these, but I'm going to do it anyway. So I need to buy, and what will happen is you'll see that I will only get these at appropriate levels. So if I try to buy a barn and invest now, I will be able to. But I might not be able to buy a linen belt because I'm 42. So we need barn linen vest, linen belt, and barn linen pants, and heavy linen gloves and reinforced linen cape. And that is the list that we're going to need along with the coarse thread. So let's start by getting the coarse thread. Okay. Where's the guy I can buy from?
Hello.
Okay, so to buy several of something, you'll also notice that I made, well, I didn't actually make any XP, did I? I don't think so. To buy multiples of something, what you do is you shift and click, and then you set the number. So I want 65. There's another ancient there, by the way. Okay, this might actually make me broke. Oh, I'm surprised, it's pretty cheap.
May the stars guide you.
Okay, so.
Peace be with you.
My suggestion is that you only buy the things that you need. Like, I need barn and vest and belt. I'm only going to buy those. When I need the other things, I will come back and I will buy all the rest from her. Like, for example, I'm not going to buy a simple dress or the shirts here. Because they are not going to help me level up. Okay, so I want the barn, I believe I want the barn and vest. Do I? Yes, barn and vest, linen belt. Okay, I want this. And if I train, I'm going to learn it. We'll see, I'll get animated. And now I know that thing. I need bone bolt. I think I need brown linen pants. Yeah, I do. I'm surprised I can get heavy linen gloves. Because that is a little ways away. Heavy linen gloves. I need reinforced linen cape. There. Now you'll notice that I can't see that in the list, and that is because I need to make all these other things first.
Goddess, watch over you.
Okay, so we want tailoring, and we want to make the brown linen vest, I believe. Yes. But, now, here's the thing. We've made two, we only need to make three to get to 45. So we are only going to make three, because we're going to end up with some coarse thread over, which is good for us. Okay, so we're going to create the three. Now don't create all, because that will go and use up your supply of coarse thread and bolts. So you want to create here. So you say three, and then you create. Okay, now notice that's gone yellow immediately, because that is the threshold for this. Now we're going to do linen belt. I believe, yes. We're going to make five of those. I'm showing off some of my secret tech about how I record. Five. Create. You can't actually see the bar going up here because it is over there. There we go. And we need leaf brown linen pants. We made the linen belt, we need brown linen pants. Great. And then we need to make heavy linen gloves, and we need to make five of those. Okay, so now we need to... Oops. Well, I'm going to stop my timer, by the way, because we're going to run a little bit over.
What brings you here?
Now you can see, I can see more stuff that I can make. And the next thing I need is the reinforced linen cape. Yes. And this is the last bump, so I need the last 15 from there. Reinforced linen cape. Train.
Illume light your path.
Tailoring. Reinforced linen cape. I can make 15, and I've only got those, but I'm going to be careful, because remember, I don't want to run out. It will take three, but that's fine. I'm going to create those.
I cannot carry anymore.
Oh. We ran into a problem. This is a problem I wasn't sure if we were going to have or not, but we do. All the stuff is our stuff that we've made now. Now, some of it's wearable. Like, for example, that's possibly wearable, because that's three armor, and what we have is about the same. This is potentially wearable, but the gloves I've got are much, much better. The belt is not wearable at all, as you can see. The pants are not wearable at all. As you can see, and we've got a lot of those capes, so we're going to sell all this stuff, because it is no longer useful. So, oh, right, we made the vest, not useful. Sell. So you can make some of your money back by doing this, but, okay, I've got to be careful not to sell the linen thread or the bolts of cloth, because that would be bad. Okay. But it won't always be like this as a prophet so far. It won't always be this way. I gotta be careful now. So I only want to sell that. But not anything else. Right.
Good luck, friend.
Professions. Tailoring, where's my reinforced there? And how many can I make? I can make 5. I only want to make exactly 5. Alright, and now we're at 75. Now this is the threshold for this level, so anytime you make any one of these now, like you can see, yeah, I can make heavy linen gloves and that might give me a skill up, but it won't because I'm at 75. I need to take the next level of tailoring over here, which is journeyman tailor. You need at least 50 in tailoring, and you need at least level 10 to take this. But once you've taken it, you'll see that the bar increases from 75 to 150, and that is the next level
up.
Go
in peace.
Anyhow, that is tailoring in a nutshell, and that is how you do that. Tomorrow, I'm going to take you through the early parts of Darnassus just to show you another slightly different system. And then, I'm not sure what we're going to do about that, but after that, but I'll think about it. Thank you so much for watching. I've been your host, Lostwolfe. This has been episode 23 of World of Warcraft Leveling. I hope you've enjoyed this, and I will see you soon. Have a great evening, folks, and goodbye.